In this tutorial, we'll be showing you how easy it is to take any design and get it printed onto a t-shirt with Sticker Mule. Let's jump in. First, depending on your design, it may be easiest to submit your artwork as is. All you need to do is place your order on the Sticker Mule website by selecting the color and sizes you want, upload your artwork, and choose how you would like it positioned. And to ensure you're happy with how it looks, we'll even provide you with a proof before printing. Something not right? Let us know and we'll make the adjustment for you, free of charge. If, however, you're looking for more control over your design, using our t-shirt template is the way to go. Go to stickermule.com/templates or click on the templates link at the bottom of the Sticker Mule site. Then, under More, select t-shirt templates. Download the provided files. Because the artwork area on our t-shirts scales with size, the same template can be used to print t-shirts ranging from small to double XL. With the template open in Adobe Illustrator, we're ready to design our t-shirt. To start, we want to ensure that we're placing our designs on the correct layer. Notice how there's a layer for the instructions. We'll keep this locked and put all of our designs on the artwork layer. This gray box is our printable area. Any elements that we put inside this box will be printed. Anything outside of it will not. The elements we'll be using for this shirt come from a fictitious company named CourierBot. I'm going to grab a robot and a little text bubble to lay out on our shirt. I'll just copy them and paste them into the artwork layer. Notice how the assets get cropped when they're outside of the printable area. Let's make sure we don't lose them. These elements are looking a little small, so I'm going to make them bigger and position them in a way that I think will look good when printed on a t-shirt. I think this layout works well. If you want to get a good idea of how your design is going to look on a colored t-shirt, you can create a new layer, put it underneath artwork, and try out any colors that you're thinking of printing on. For this shirt, I'm thinking red. So with the rectangle tool, I'll just make a red shape that sits beneath my artwork. This will give me a better visual idea of how it's going to look. If, like me, you have text in your design, it's always a good idea to outline it into paths. Just right-click your text and select Create Outlines. One thing I'm noticing with the red t-shirt is that these blue elements aren't standing out very well. So I'm going to change the blue to white. And now that the text is lost, I'm going to change it to this deep maroon color. And while we're working with colors, it's worth mentioning that when possible, you should work in RGB. Because this speech bubble is sitting right against the edge of the printable area, I'm going to use Outline Preview just to make sure it's not getting cropped. Currently, we have two reds. We have the red of the design, and we have the red of the t-shirt fabric. It's totally fine to print this just as it is if I wanted to have a subtly different red in the hat than the t-shirt, but I'd actually like these to be both the same red. Because they're so similar, I think this will make it more cohesive. To do this, all I need to do is delete the red elements. By doing this, nothing will get printed in that area, and the red of the t-shirt fabric will be shown. I've also decided that I want the word thing to have the red of the t-shirt, and so I will subtract that shape from the speech bubble to once again expose what's beneath. Notice now how if I change the background color, the hat, the buttons, the word thing, these are all changing because whatever color the t-shirt is, that's what color these elements will be. Now we're just about finished here, but there's one last thing to do. We're going to make a few of these colors a bit more vibrant to offset any fading that might happen when these t-shirts are washed. The easiest way to do this is to go into the color panel, switch it to HSB, and on the saturation slider, just increase it some. We'll do it for the green as well. And as a final tweak, we'll make the maroon color a bit darker, just for contrast. And there, that's looking good. If you added a layer to test out different t-shirt colors, just make sure that you delete that before you save and submit for printing. Now our t-shirt is ready to print. If your artwork is raster-based, such as a JPEG or PNG, the process is the same. Just drop your design into the artwork layer and position it as desired. Simple. Remember, just as with our other products, you can always request as many changes as you need before sending your design off to print. So if you're ever in doubt about how your t-shirt is going to look, just submit it and see. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and click the bell to stay up to date on future videos. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.